Welcome back, Trinidad and Tobago. And you're one to laugh, welcome and laugh. That's what they have as their poster. And Hamidoula, did I get the pronunciation correctly?
Hamidoula.
Hamidoula. And we have Deaf Prince on set with us this morning, and we're talking about taking Calypso to the schools and Zando and all part of Calypso History Month. But this event is coming to laugh. Tell me about it.
Well, first of all, it's Calypso History Month. And quite naturally, we in South Central Zone of Tuku, we pride ourselves in being able to share the program with the bigger organizations it is. So we say, you want to laugh, come and laugh. It's on the 3rd of November, that Saturday come in. And we have people like Crow, Crazy, Protector, Damian Melvin, Trisha Hamilton, Kit Kalaloo, Mr. Mark, Anson Douglas, El Drago, Alicia Richards, and Duff Prince.
Now, Deaf Prince, you're part of this event.
Yes, I am.
So let's talk about when you say you want to laugh, come. What is obviously a comedy show, but how are you going to appeal to different types of the audience and the different personalities in the audience and still inject Calypso History Month in it?
Well, actually, it's a Calypso show using humor genre,
okay,
which is comedy. Okay, so all of the artists will be more or less doing something on the humor side. Okay, so we have people like El Drago, who's an old veteran in the dance. We have Uncle Crazy, Miss Alicia. She's very dramatic. She's like an animated version of Calypso. You see her perform the antics and everything. It's amazing. So the show is on the 3rd of this month. Sorry, next month. And all are invited. Only $100, and the proceeds goes to help. Part of the proceeds, goes to help the flood victims.
And you know, you talk about Calypso History Month, and we said goodbye to the Mighty Shadow yesterday. Yeah. They question about Calypso and the relevance of Calypso. When you come to these shows, are you seeing new, young talent and new faces?
When you're talking in terms of the audience?
Yes.
Well, we could do better, but we're getting one or two coming through still. But what we're hoping is that the parents, the adults, would not bring the trend to the show, because a show like this is very much for the kids and them. It's very much a family show as it is.
What are you looking forward to most in this show?
Well, to satisfy the people and let them know that Calypso is alive.
Do you think Calypso, what does the next generation of Calypso look like to you? As one of the veterans, what do you think the next level of Calypso is going to be?
Well, I'm not too sure I understand the question really, but if they feel that that Calypso is dying, as they would say, certainly that's not the case. Once we keep on doing what we're doing, like in this case, we go to the schools and try to encourage the trend, bringing the art form to them. We are very hopeful that our next generation will be just as dynamite as this one.
Difference, when you look at the young people, do they get it? Do they understand where Calypso has come from, the genre? Do they understand the evolution of Calypso?
Well, to be honest with you, it has to do with their upbringing. Mm-hmm. Because some children will know about the old veterans, etc., and they know about Calypso, okay? Some, on the other hand, all you know is soca. So I think that is why we need shows like this to promote the Calypso, because it's not a dying art. It could be a dying art form, if you allow it. Okay, but there are some young people coming into the art form. We have Helan Francis. He was a student of Woodbrook Secondary for 5 years, and he won all the competitions in his school. When he came back out, you know what happens. So he's a pretty young guy. I don't think he crossed 25 yet. And there are a lot of other people who are interested in the art form, but it's just not highlighted.
Tell us about the show, daytime details.
Well, first of all, I must let you know that the ambience you have is very nice one, in that we have air-conditioned environment as it is in City Hall. We have our own police who have protected us, because these are concerned about crime. Your vehicle can be taken care of, so all that is within the package. And we both say too that it's a bargain, not a begging, because at $100 for all that kind of entertainment, you can't go wrong.
So it is a lot in making sure that you are fully taken care of. So it's featuring the men and women who make you laugh, and you have names like Crow, Anselm Douglas, and everyone else. Well, we've come to the end of today's show. On behalf of everyone attached to the show, I wish you a safe and blessed day, Trinidad and Tobago. Have a good one, and keep smiling today. I hope you get some sunshine, not green clouds, in your day and your atmosphere. And I will see you tomorrow morning, God's willing. And as we end, we're going to share with you excerpts of the rendition done by the Signal Hill Choir. And this was done as we said goodbye to the Mighty Shadow, an icon gone but not forgotten. And I will see you tomorrow morning. Have a happy Wednesday. And also, it's Halloween. What are you doing? Trick or treating? Goodbye, Trinidad and Tobago.